I'm a minority.
I'm a minority.
Soy un minoría.
I'm a minority.
I am Gitman.
When I was 17, I was at a park with some friends, and one of my friends did an underdog, you know, and they push you and walk under you, and I fell out of the swing, landed on my stomach, and snapped my back in two. I was instantly paralyzed. And my friends, I remember rolling up and sitting straight up trying to catch my breath, and my friends were panicked and scared, and I remember saying, oh my God, I can't feel my legs. So my friend picked me up and carried me to his car, and two of the other girls that were with us couldn't get his car door open. So he went to lean me up against the car. I was already paralyzed, so I fell and slid under the car and onto the sidewalk. So once he got the car door open, he had to pull me out from there, pick me back up, and put me in the seat and take me to the emergency room. So it's kind of ugly. So I had my accident right before I started my senior year in high school. So I missed out on the first whole fall semester. And when I returned, no one talked to me. I used to be that kid at school that everybody knew. I never really had my own clique. And then I was, you know, ostracized to Siberia for the most part. No one wanted to talk to me, spend time with me, even look at me.
Me being Costa Rican, people would always make fun of me of, you know, like, they would say I'm here illegally, and they'd always make up stories about how I would get here, you know. They would always call me racial slurs too, especially in this one class. Well, it obviously made me ashamed. During lunch, I could hear them when I would pass by. In every other class, I could always hear them just talking about me.
So when I first came to Fossil, I was just kind of sticking with the group of friends that I'd known from like junior high and from elementary school because I felt comfortable. And when I first got here, it was that you stuck with your own groups and you had your own little stereotypical groups. And I started hanging out with a couple of my Hispanic friends, and they had like their own group. And so when I was hanging out with them when they were with their group, I wasn't like Hispanic enough for some of them or Mexican enough for some of them, and I come from a full Hispanic heritage, and so it kind of felt like I was being like judged on how Mexican or how Hispanic I was. And eventually like I hung out with them more and more, and they finally figured out that I was full Hispanic, and they didn't like judge me as much anymore, but they were still kind of like, oh, well, now you're with us and you can't hang out with anybody else. Like, you can't hang out with white people, or you can't hang out with other people because we're the Mexican, you know, Brown Pride group and other things like that.
A lot of people prejudge me for my ethnicity and my cultural background, and they expect me to act or behave a certain way. Well, most of the reactions I get are actually positive. Like, people expect me to be really smart or be really talented in certain ways, and like, it's just a lot to live up to.
Every time I walk through halls, either I get looked at really weird, funny, or even during class, people don't even talk to me because either I look mean or they don't like my style, or just, I don't know. It ain't really about how I dress, it's my personality. If you really get to know me, I ain't really that person between these clothes. And what's out there, it ain't really me, it's what's inside of you.
We were in class one day and a teacher called me out for having a disability. She started talking about the differences that I had from the other students in front of everyone. I never thought of myself being different, not being able to see out of an eye, but the way she made me feel, I felt different.
And I think that made it made such an impact on my life that not only did I struggle through the rest of my senior year in high school, but when I started college, I ended up failing out my first year, my first semester, because I just felt so different. I didn't know how to cope with that. I didn't know how to deal with that. And I feel like if my friends would have just kind of rallied around me a little bit better, that may have made that transition a little better for me. And I understand high school's hard, but it was a tough time.
Well, really, I mean, like, if, you know, they're not being called that, and it really hurt me being called that and everything, so I, like, if they were called that, it would hurt them really bad because, you know, words affect you, like, and they can scar you emotionally, you know. You probably can't show it on the outside, but, you know, inside it'll scar you.
Diversity is important because it singles out the differences in everybody, and it turns it into a good thing rather than a bad thing, making us all equal.
I believe that diversity is important just because nobody should feel singled out or discriminated against or not feel comfortable in a situation that they're put in or their environment, like especially at school. Nobody should not want to go to school because of the way they're treated or just not feeling like they fit in. It's important for them to be a part of everything.
I just don't think that people realize what they say or how they say things can actually hurt people.
Spreading diversity is definitely hard, but it's not impossible. I think the best solution would be to have something kind of like the Chain Reaction Day, but have, like, because we have Diversity Day coming up, and with that, I think groups should be mixed and that people should definitely get a chance to hear everybody's story, because we each all have an individual story, and by sharing that, we wouldn't judge as much, we'd spread our group of friends more, and we'd be hanging out with more than just one group of people.
If people just thought about what they said and how they said things, that it would be able to make a difference.
I feel like diversity, accepting it, comes with, like having a diverse society, and right now Fossil isn't very diverse, but I feel like we become more diverse every year. And so, I don't know, like getting involved, I guess everyone getting involved and like having the mindset of like equality and like no prejudice.
You shouldn't be able to judge no one that you really don't know, and the way they dress. You should get to know that person first and realize that ain't that person what he seems like.
So, it'd be nice if they like got to know me first, and then, you know, some of the pressure is taken away.
Throughout the school, I think the main thing is just to make other people aware of what it feels like to be discriminated against, and informing people of the differences that there are, and just having everybody accept each other for who they are, and just, I think the big thing is awareness, is letting people know what it feels like, and letting them know that it's not okay to discriminate against people, or treat them differently because of a difference that they have.
Well, obviously there's going to be Diversity Day, and that's going to change a lot of people's minds about, you know, what they say and how easy it is to affect someone with just, you know, one word, you know, one racial slur.
Our school isn't that diverse as itself, so to promote what we do have, I think is really important in just getting to know people on a different level.
So I think here at Fossil Ridge, it's wonderful how people are welcoming and they're friendly to all types of individuals, no matter what their disability or their ethnicity or their religion. And I think that as long as you can keep that with you and be that person that doesn't judge a book by their cover and really gets to know somebody for who they are, then Fossil Ridge is going to be an incredible school to want to be here, no matter who you are.
Accepting each other, I think, is the big number one, and just getting to know people, I think, because people just are really clicky, and I think branching out would be a big help.
United in Diversity to me means that we all just come together and create a big family, and that not one person is singled out because they're different, because of their race, because of an ability that they have. Just being together and being comfortable in our situation.
I pledge from this day forward to do my best to combat prejudice
and to stop those who, because of hate or ignorance,
would hurt people or violate their civil rights. I will try at all times to be aware of my own biases and seek to gain understanding of those I perceive as
being different from myself. I will speak out against all forms of
prejudice and discrimination.
I will reach out and support those who are targets of hate.
I will think about specific ways
my community members can promote respect for people
and create a prejudice-free zone. I firmly believe that one person
can make a difference and that no person can be
an innocent bystander when it comes to opposing hate. I recognize that respecting individual dignity,
achieving equality, and promoting intergroup harmony are the
responsibilities of all people.
By signing this pledge,
I commit myself
to making a positive impact
on my community.